The people should praise you. The people should be aware of your position in society. Immediately, you feel the need to inform others. This is where the problem lies. The Holy Sixth Imam says, if an individual performs an action fi sabilillah sincerely, and they hide it from the other human beings to the extent that his left hand doesn't see it from his right hand, that he's doing it on his right hand and his left hand is concealed. This is how secretive he is when he's doing something fi sabilillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him a special amount of reward reserved for those who are sincere. The Imam alayhi salam says, if however that individual would call and inform somebody in the community that I gave so much for a particular cause, or I helped this individual who came to ask me, the reward would reduce drastically. It'll still be rewarded, it's a good deed. However, the Imam says, if the number of people who are told about this deed increases to 2, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change this hasana into the act of riyah, of showing off. No longer will you get any reward. No longer will you be the recipient of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala's blessings and maghfirat, but it is will be written as riya'. It is a very dangerous spiritual disease that exists in the hearts of human beings. We are seeking other people's approval and pleasure continuously rather than seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's pleasure. Rather than seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's maghfirat. The late Ayatullah al-Uzma, Sheikh Bahjat, rahmatullahi alayhi, one of the great urafa, says, as far as showing off is concerned, it is permissible. Don't get ideas. He says it is permissible. However, who do you want to show off to? Normally, we go to people of authority, people who can change things, who we think have respect in the community. Allah subhanahu the holy Sheikh Bahjat says, when it comes to showing off, the only permissible showing off is to show off to Allah. Sit in front of Allah and say, oh Allah, I've done X, Y, and Z, because it is Allah who can help you, no one else. It is Allah who can bestow you with maghfirah, with rahmah, with jannah, and nobody else. Why would you go to other people when you know that the absolute perfect being is the source of all goodness? That is why we find in the Quran this emphasis upon making sure that riya doesn't creep in our minds, in our hearts, in our setup, in our actions. The question that is normally asked is, how do we know if we are sincere? What are the characteristics of the mukhlaseen? Of those who have purified their intention for Allah. Because everything has a sign. لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلَامَةٍ. Everything has a sign by which we can categorize. Today, if you are a physician or if you are an engineer, you come forward and you present the evidence that you have this qualification. What are the characteristics of the مُخْلِصِين? Those who are sincere. Number one, they are not seeking praise of others. They do actions and they're not seeking praise of others. The problem is, as we mentioned, we are continuously looking for others to shower their praise upon us. I remember in America, three brothers, they built a mosque. Their names was Ibrahim, Musa, and Karim. They built a mosque. When they built a mosque, they asked the Mawlana, they said, Mawlana, we want you to bless this mosque and to perform the namaz. He came and he started to perform the namaz. The first namaz in that mosque. The three brothers stood behind the Mawlana and the congregation behind him. He recited Suratul A'la. The final verse in Suratul A'la is what? Suhufi Ibrahim wa Musa. The palms or the books of Ibrahim and Musa. Kareem, who is standing to Ibrahim and Musa. So what's going on here? Ibrahim and Musa are mentioned and I am not mentioned. So he waits until the namaz is finished. He sits next to the Mawlana. He says, Mawlana, sahab, don't forget me in dua, huh? You know, my name is Kareem. So the Mawlana said, okay, no problem. in order to teach him a lesson, the second namaz, he recites Surah Ala again, and he says, Suhufi Ibrahim wa Musa. This man thinking, this Mawlana has a problem with me. The idea is that we are seeking this remembrance of our name when it comes to good actions. The characteristic of a mukhlas is that they are not looking for praise from others. They are solely looking for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be pleased with them, and that is sufficient for them. That is enough. Number one. Number two, what you get, what you see is what you get. In other words, when they are with others, with other human beings, other members of the community, they are active. When they are at home, alone, and nobody's looking at them, they are also active. They are also standing up and down in prostration and in sujood. They are also praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala earnestly and sincerely. Because the problem is sometimes when we are surrounded by others, we become all of a sudden, we have the injection of activity in order for others to see that we are of the righteous. It is said that an individual, 20 years of his lifetime, he would attend namaz jama'at, congregation prayer. And every time he would come and he would stand on the first row. One day he was late, he came back, he prayed on the second row. When he finished, he said, my namaz is different today. I don't feel the same. What's the problem with my namaz today? He realized all this time, there was this feeling of pride and arrogance in his heart that he was performing the namaz and the first level. And that was a dangerous thing to adopt over this time. Another individual goes to an area, he says, I don't want anybody to see me worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I don't want to show off. He stands in this old mosque. Nobody's there. He's praying. All of a sudden he hears a movement behind him. And then the sujood becomes longer. The sujood becomes longer. The salah is prolonged. And he finishes and he looks and it's a cat that just walked in into the mosque. And he says, Allahu Akbar. I used to show off for human beings. Now I show off for animals. The danger is this, that when we do not accept, when we have this dichotomous relationship with others, when we have this hypocrisy, then that is a disease that exists within our hearts. Number two. Number three, the Holy Prophet of Islam, Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, in a famous narration says, من قال لا إله إلا الله مخلصا فله الجنة. Whomsoever utters the beautiful, fragrant words of La ilaha illallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him paradise. But this utterance of La ilaha illallah needs to be coupled with action. That the sincerity that you and I are eager in order to practice and to make part and parcel of our lives needs to be manifested in our daily activities. Something that was demonstrated by our ulama. The author of Jam'u al-Sa'adat, the collection of felicities, is Allama Shaykh al-Naraqi. You have seen his book. Allama Shaykh al-Naraqi one day came to Iraq. He was in Iraq. He was visiting the ulama. It so happens that there was a great alim, Shaykh Sayyid Mahdi Bahr al-Ulum, there. It so happens that this Sayyid wanted to test the sincerity of Shaykh al-Naraqi. So Shaykh al-Naraqi comes to visit Sayyid Bahr al-Ulum. Remember that this book is the book of Akhlaq. It talks about ethics and mannerism. So Shaykh al-Naraqi enters the house of Sayyid Bahr al-Ulum. Sayyid Bahr al-Ulum is sitting on the floor. He sits and he says, Salam. The Sayyid answers him back, says, Alaykum as-salam. He wonders, why is the Sayyid not welcoming me? Why is he not showing some kind of expression of happiness and gratitude that I have come to visit him? The Sayyid is silent, is looking on the floor, doing nothing. So the Shaykh sits down, says to him, how are you? He says, I'm fine. He says to him, how is everything here? Everything's okay. He says, may Allah bless you and grant you long life. And I've just come to say salam to you. And that's all. And then he comes, he kisses his cheeks, and he goes. Shaykh al-Naraqi goes. Sayyid Bahr al-Ulum immediately stands up, follows him to the door and says, you have passed the test. He says, what is the test? He said, I wanted to demonstrate to people that you were sincere. When you wrote that book of Akhlaq, you did not only write it in theory, but you demonstrated it in action as well. That is why I did what I did, so that I show people that look, even though I was cold to you, even though I didn't respond to you, your actions resembled your speech and what is inside your heart. What we need to learn in this holy month of Ramadan, the month of maghfirah, rahmah, the great month of lessons that you and I need to pass with superb flying colors by the time of Eid, is this ikhlas. We need to inculcate it in our actions. We need to make it part and parcel of our existence. What do we mean? We need to make it a habit that we think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and everything that we do is for Allah, and try to filter out any actions that we do for other human beings. We try to limit or reduce or completely remove it from our behavioral characteristics. We need to learn this and practice this in order for us to be raised among the people who are indeed named or known as sincere servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين.